is Queen Nija, and in today's video, I will be reacting to the, well, it is also the movie, but the four-parter episode series of Kaguya-sama. I'm about to say Love is War. Love is the first kid. I'm already fucking it up. The Kaguya-sama Love is War movie. There you go. I already knew I was gonna screw it up. Okay, so this was something, of course, that was already in the back of my burner that I knew I was going to have to get done. And I was like, I need to find a day. And it was funny because last week on part one vacation, I had a lot of people asking me, like, oh, was I going to watch it? And da 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 da. And I was like, yeah. I was just like, you know, hey, I kind of want to wait until, like, majority of my shows start and then, you know, instantly try to, like, maneuver my time. And then, you know, same thing with, like, week two and having people ask me, like, hey, you want to watch this and stuff? And then I'm, like, busy as hell. But, I mean, yes, I am excited to see this. I love the fact that it's in a four-part episode series because we're all doing it in one whole video. You're not getting two parts in two videos. You're just getting it all in one part. So, of course, this is going to be the longest fucking edit that I'm probably going to do. And I'm going to be very tired by the end of this. Point in case I'm doing this at 1 o'clock in the fucking morning and it's like, ugh. But I am ready to laugh, probably cry, maybe. More in laughing than crying. Because I already cried with the other show that, you know, we will not name. But other than that, let's go ahead and get started with episode one in 3, 2, 1, go. I mean, well, yeah. I mean, it's true, though. Yes, the whole world revolves around sex and shit. Sex sells. Oh, my baby. Once again, I'm still proud of you. You did so good. All right, Kaguya, you're going too much into your Paimon, you know, emergency food. We'd like to tone it down, babe. I love it, though. Yeah, we know, we know. Like, woo, that kiss right there, that was too much. Let me check my phone real quick. I'll read that after. Because everybody always wants to respond to me right as I'm going to watch something else. I mean, you know, in a way, you kind of did with the kiss. Well, not like the. Not with the tongue, babe, but you know, I mean, in my opinion, I consider y'all boyfriend and girlfriend. Shit. Y'all kissed! Besides, sure, Bonnie, it's gonna be okay. Hi, baby. A girl in love. Denial and oh my God. That's when I'd be like, all right, you know what? All the freaking selfies. Yes, gotta take the baby. I mean, no, that one, you read the spicy ones. You did the ones where they want to fuck, baby. You know, you can't do that all the time. But you don't always really do that in public. You do that one type in private, you know, when it's you and your man. Are you a woman? I'm just saying. No! Right? Do we really have to talk about this? But it is. It equals that, baby. Right? I mean, But it's obvious, Kaguya. I mean, children like you. Ain't she asleep? But Kaguya, do you even think you're ready to have sex, baby? I mean, but the thing is, it depends on the couple. She right though. I mean, because you was just ready to go to Pound Town, maybe. You can't do that. I know. I'm sorry. I hate the fact that you had to find out that way. Well, you know, we gonna have to wait till tomorrow. Oh, yes, baby. Just like I said, take all the damn pictures. You're so freaking cute. She got me. We don't want to talk about that so much. I know. Like, what is your problem with hitting someone in the boob? Like, no, that hurts. I mean, she don't really look like it, Chica, but you know, hey.
No.
Number two.
No.
Winning them over with some donuts.
No. Uh-oh. Oh, no. No.
Oh my God. Yeah, just wait until tomorrow. Yeah, you're right. It is the size of an orange. Goodbye. This is it. This is like the cutest shit I've ever seen. Oh my God. My best girl! Once again, my best girl comes in at the wrong fucking time! Mm-hmm. Of course. I'm not surprised. See, but no, it's gonna be like a Christmas party. See? No! Yes, you would have, baby. And you would have been the clueless one at the end. Well, not anymore. I would have considered that as a yes. I mean, damn, she's still asleep. Chica, my baby, I love her so much. But she go low. She go low. Yeah, they're both going to a Christmas party. Keychain. Oh, you say that now, baby. So, you want to talk about the little ish? Not the death penalty. Oh, my God. True, yes, and you reciprocated those feelings by kissing him. So, I mean, officially, once again, you guys are a couple, even though he didn't ask you to be his girlfriend. Child Kaguya. Right? I mean, I would say still, once again, you're lovers. You know what? Say it again for the people in the back. You right about that. But still, he didn't ask you. He needed to ask you. Or you could have asked him. I can't. Oh my god. Right. You know, no, I don't think he thinks you're, you know, the super less, you know, sex monster, baby, but I mean, you could just ask him. There is nothing wrong with asking your quote-unquote significant other how they see you. There's nothing wrong if the woman wants to be the first one to go into the kiss. Trust me. Right? I mean, we're in the 21st fucking century. The woman can go first. Yes, I know that. Yeah, because you can't really go around kissing everybody. Right? It is. It truly is. No, baby, get it up! Rip zipper rare Kaguya! Waking up. Oh. cold, baby. That cold shoulder. No. No, 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 no. I don't like that. I don't want that. No, 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 no. And I get it. I understand why she wants that version of her to pop up at this moment, but still, like, but no, we needed the one who is uber sensitive to come in and be like, yes. Yes, sure, I got it. Like, I want to be a couple. I want you to be together. Oh my god. Like, Jesus Christ. Baby! Dang, these next three episodes could go anyway, isn't it? Like, woo! I mean, like, okay. My thing is he gonna have to kiss her to just bring them back together? I don't know. I mean, because, like, okay, yes. I get the feeling of, okay, we're in the modern day era. We all like it when, you know, the woman is like, I'm going to take the initiative. I'm going to kiss you and such. I mean, I would, if it's me and my boyfriend, yes, I will take that initiative. But if it's the other way around, because sometimes I rather would like it, just in my opinion as well. I want the guy to take it first. I mean, like, it's something about, I blame anime. I do. I blame movies. I blame TV shows. I blame books for making me feel a certain type of way of when a guy kisses you first and when a guy takes that lead. Like, whoever you have a crush on takes the initiative lead of doing the first kiss and such. It's just, it's something about that that is just like, oh my god, like, yes. 1,000 times, yes. And then when you're just following through, like, yeah. But yeah, baby, you got schooled about tongue kissing. I mean, oh. Woo. What are you doing? I mean, we all knew it was gonna come. Because my thing was, going back to the kiss, with their first kiss and such, I was thinking it was just a regular, simple kiss that just, they were there for a long time. Not just smacking the ish out of him with your tongue. Girl! No, 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 no. That, like I said, that is when you, it's just you and him. But in that moment, it was just them. I get it. Like, yes, it's cute. It's not supposed to be hot and heavy with the first damn kiss. It's supposed to make you, like, it's like a tease to eventually get in the hot and heavy stuff. Like, yes, girl, I know you. I know that feeling. Like, God, yes. But once again, it's good when a guy takes the lead. Oh, my God. And such. Yes, but I know that feeling. We, every female in us, when we are for, you know, when it's a guy kissing us, yes, we all want that feeling. It feels good, trust me. But still, like, damn. Kaguya, baby. Then I feel for her. She's like, oh my god, he might think I'm a slut. Like, a less sex craze whore. But like, no, Kaguya, he don't think that about you, baby. It's okay. It's okay. He probably was a little surprised about that kiss. I think maybe, like, if any guy possibly would be surprised about that. I mean, you know, because depending on, like, the girl in the situation, and I can, okay, I'm not only speaking about when I'm thinking, when I say guy, I'm also meaning, like, both sides and stuff, but since I am someone who is a girl who likes me some dudes at the same time and such, I feel like even if it's the same way, when, okay, because it was really funny because earlier in the day, I saw this random ass tweet, and we were talking about when us females, us girls, when we are quote unquote asking for it. Any picture we take or whatever, everybody, guys initially always think we're asking for it. Not all the time, bro. Not all the fucking time. Sometimes we just want to talk to you and such. If I was asking for it, I would literally tell you I am fucking asking for it. I'm not asking for it. I'm asking you how your day was. Did you do anything today? How was work? How was the weather in your freaking state or in your country, in your city, in the town, whatever? And then when I'm ready to say, hey, I'm kind of asking for it, then yeah, I kind of ask for it and such. And but yeah, in a way, Kaguya, I know your feeling, babe. Like, truly, truly. But yeah, next time when you do kiss him, don't go all the way with the tongue. just do a regular, simple kiss. Let it be hot and heavy on that kiss, and then you just let go, and you let that be the freaking tease for you for the next couple of dates and stuff. Then, when you are ready, 2 months later, 3 months later, 4 months later, can you really go 4 months later without having sex? Then you do the tongue kissing. Only when you're ready, though. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. But I feel like this, with cold, ice cold Kaguya, long hair down Kaguya, and, you know, Shirogane, and this next part, I don't know how this is going to go. I feel like, one, Shirogane might think, like, okay, now that she's like this, is she not really into me? Does she want to say, like, fuck the kiss that happened and such? Are we calling this off? Are you not going to go to America with me? There's a lot of things that they could do in these next three episodes, but of course we gotta wait and see. But go ahead and pause the video, and I will see you guys in 1 second for part two. Alrighty, part two in 3, 2, 1, go. Do not ask. A lot has happened in the last couple of minutes at the end of part one going on to part two. It got freezing cold in my room. I had to change into some longer sweats because I had shorts on. And I'm still cold. This tastes horrible. Don't know. You when you're at work, that too. No, not right now, not like this. You don't sound so sure about that. Mm-hmm. Well, because yes, she likes you. Ma'am, don't say it like that. Hurry and do it before somebody walks in. Kinda not really cold anymore. Baby. No. Oh, you just hurt his pride as a man. Not by yourself. No, baby, she doesn't have a fiance, or does she? Read between the lines. That goofy ass walk. This is where we part. Oh, baby, not you too. Depression. Oh my God. No, you just started counting coffins, baby. We're gonna fix this. No, don't go by yourself. For now. That cold shoulder, I think. That go land. Ooh! Seriously? Oh my god, baby. Yes, but she's also weird today. Let's try. My baby go low. When she go low, she go low. Kaguya. Girl, is she a runner? She a track star? Girl, my girl is like a Spider-Man. Oh my god. Well, you know, we're just mysterious, babe. That's a lie. We all know it. I mean, he would, but not when you're like this, babe.
My baby, she can't get the shit out of him. Oh my god. Like, no, of course not. No, 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 no. But, like, yes! Yeah. No, 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 it's fine.
You know, some of us are, we're just really good talkers and stuff when, you know, we're talking about our romance and stuff.
Not on top of Mount Fuji.
I know, yeah, but she ready to be honest. Yeah, you all know that, like, they have crushes on each other. but he's not falling in those feelings. He's not kissing her. What else do we need? Do we need to create a sign? No. Kaicho, I want you to kiss me. Yes. It just got colder in here again. Right, yeah, because you want to, like, you know, celebrate that. Yes, you can. You get nervous. I get that. I mean, every girl gets nervous with their crush. Trust me, like, I've done that shit too. Like, good. Yeah, and some guys don't get the point. You'd be like, oh my god. Be like, hey, I'm cold. Like, super cold. Oh my god. Bingo! Give that girl a prize! A really good grown-up kiss, but you know, we don't talk about that. Well, and it just happened. Yeah, it wasn't like it was somewhere else where it was just you two. It was in front of a marketplace. Girl, you don't want no spice. Help her. Go on. Girl, still running. Oh god, it's just okay. Once again, Kaguya, my baby girl, I agree with you. Like, once again, we're going into this. Yes, you want the guy or girl that you have a crush on to just read them signs. You read them signs when you are just literally giving them a hint. Me sometimes, like, when I am... So, okay, I'll tell you a little thing. So, when I am flirting, and sometimes I do this to the point that I realize I don't do this. It's just, you know how, like, something's so naturally to you? So, I smile a lot. I will, if my hair is like this, or if my hair is longer, or my hair is just, like, you know, straightened or whatever, I do the, you know, gotta curl my beaky hair, engage into the conversation and stuff, because, you know, hey, even though, like, because some people think when I do that, they think I'm bored and such, and I'm like, no, I'm really into the freaking conversation. I'm listening to you. Do you have a problem with me listening to you? That's what you need to do. Listen! Read the room! Read the freaking room! What is your problem? Read the room! Sarah Goddard, my baby, my love. Read that room. She wants you to take the initiative to take the lead. Like, oh my god, just take it and run with it. Oh my god, like, please. And so I'm just hoping in these last two episodes that we have left that he does take the initiative. Like, I mean, yes, we've gone over this time and time before with these two. It's just that, once again, the will they, won't they. And, you know, finally, when they kissed, even though it was a grown-up kiss, you wish, baby, my Kaguya, my girly, she was in the right mind and not her cold, icy self, because, of course, she just feels a certain type of way. And I get it. Like, even with her saying, you know, her hands are cold and Shirogane is not getting the, you know, the message applies. Like, oh, you want me to hold your hand and such. Or, you know, just, like, kind of cuddle for a second so we can both warm up and such. Guys. Men. Because, you know, I gotta say it towards you. Please, once again, just read the room. Read the room. When we say something, we'll be like, oh my god. Like, if we see someone, like a guy, as a couple... If the boyfriend sees that the girlfriend is cold and they give his girlfriend or her girlfriend a jacket and such, and if we look at you like this and we say, oh my god, we're cold, that doesn't mean for you to be a fucking smartass and, you know, I can't do this, I can't do that, oh, I don't have a jacket, you better find something for me, like, oh my god, please and thank you and such. And then, yeah, you might get something, you know, later on, don't you? Just saying about that. But, I mean, at the end of the day, it's just, you hope that by the end of this, which, of course, it's going to happen, they're going to have a better talk where she is more herself and not her mask and, you know, her facade and everything, because you do feel extremely bad for her, because, yes, even now, she's still putting up all these guards up and... using her ice persona back as her original, being like, okay, this is how I'm truthfully going to say anything. It sounds harsh, which it does really a lot when you look at, like, Ice Kaguya, because she tells it like it is, but baby go a little too low sometimes. Like I said, with Ino, when somebody goes low, Ino go lower. Baby is like, I am going to take you the fuck down. Like, I don't care what I have to do. Like, homegirl came and just instantly smelt Kaguya and was like, you're wearing perfume? Nah, we can't do that. Mm-mm. Give it to me. It's mine now. But then Kaguya's like, nope, I'm going to overtake this scene. I'm going to put this on you. And then when you eventually meet up with the person you have a crush on, then yeah, you're going to smell so freaking good. Like, yes. Makes the boys weak in the knees. Yes, 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 yes. Smelling good is so good. I'm just saying. Always smell good, please. As a PSA, I'm just saying. Even though I'm laughing right now, I'm being serious. Please smell good, regardless, all the time, 24/7. So, but yeah, I mean, now that she's, like, given Shirogane, like, the hoodie and everything, which is so cute, she even says, but I love you. She's just like this, like, one minute I'm like, yes, and then one minute I'm like, no, like, baby, honey. You just gotta wait for him. I hate to say this, and I'm not gonna say this about all guys, because all guys aren't always like this. Some guys are just not the smartest, and that is okay. It takes you guys a little bit longer. Some girls as well, I will say that too, from my friends who are relationship with girls and stuff, that it does take us a little bit longer to read the, you know, situation stuff. Anyone can be clueless, and that is okay. That's why sometimes you have to be that one to, you know, give them a little bit more ish. Be like, this is what I want. This is what I want you to do and such. And yeah, slowly but surely they end up figuring it out. And you're like, oh my God, yes, finally. Like, yes, yes, you know, you can't read your mind. So, you know, it's either you got to tell them or you eventually let them figure it out on their own. And then sometimes 50 out of 50, you will be pissed off at them. Because, like, yes, she had the right to be pissed at him. She's over here telling you, like, hey, my hands are cold. My hands are cold. Hands are cold. I need you to do something about my cold as fuck hands. And poor baby. Thinking that she has a fiance. No! Like, she only wants you and you only. That kiss really was the initiative that she wants you and only you. We all know that. Oh, baby boy. Love you so much. But go ahead and pause the video and I will see you guys in 1 second for part 3. Alrighty. Part 3 in 3, 2, 1. My depression, baby. You look good, don't it? Read the room, sure, got it. Read the room. Chica, no. 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 I don't want yours. Uh-oh. You don't mean. Please. You got this. Wake up. I don't want to do this anymore. Yes. But it's your turn. Can't be cold all the time. Baby, you made a baby cry. I know, but your own way, you are. Mm-hmm. You have. No, 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 you still do. You waking up? And you stay by his side. That's what it is. No, 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 you confront that ish head on. No. Yes, it is. Stop lying to yourself. You and Kaguya got some freaking hard edits. My hard head, babies. Oh my goodness. Right? But Kaguya accepts you as you are. No way, she's right. She sure was.
You see his ass. Oh my God.
Don't listen to. Gotta take the blend, rip it off like a Band-Aid, baby. Yes, you have to tell him before this is all over. Lie. Everybody does that. We just don't want people to see us when we're weak or anything. Because we're afraid that they'll leave us. Damn it, Deidre, I'm making myself cry. God dang it, Shell. But eventually you have to, baby. Oh, okay. I am nervous. Anything that really can happen in this next episode, aka our little finale, truly. It's just now, will, once again, they finally confess? Will they have a kiss that is a normal kiss and not as a hot and heavy lip lock wanting to go on to have sex and shit and stuff, but the fact that once again these two are so similar to the point that it's not even funny. I mean, but yeah, in a situation like I said, we don't want our significant others to see us in a certain type of way when we're struggling, we're weak, we're upset, we're crying, mad, whatever. Because of course, yeah, like sometimes it can turn people away. Some people don't want to be in situations where one minute you're like this and the next minute you're like that. Imagine if someone who has how should I word this? Let's say issues with themselves and they're not ready to bring that type of self around this significant other, because once again, yes, they feel like they're just going to run away from them. I get that, trust me, that has not happened to me. But like the only thing I can give to you is this. Okay, so there's this TV show I watch with my mom, and this show is now officially on season 4, and it's a romance reality television show. It's on Netflix, so you should already know what the heck it is. And I watch it because, you know, trash TV. Season 1 was, like, the best season, but now I feel like it just gets worse and worse by season because, in my opinion, they're trying to get a couple that is similar to one couple majority of us liked in season 1. And I feel like they still have not found that couple even by season 4. It's like a one-hit wonder, and you can never find that again. Well, there's this one couple that is no longer together. We officially found that out last Friday. But seeing their journey, there's a point where the girl necessarily goes a certain way. Let's say that. I don't want to say what it truly is, but she just goes a certain way. And when I watched that whole situation, the whole moment, I would have initially thought that typical guys, they would just book it. But the guy that she ended up, quote unquote, marrying, not in the end of the day, but at the time when they kind of got married-ish or engaged, he was there for her. He consoled her during her time of need, if she felt some type of way, because she's not only thinking of, like, her honeymoon stage with this person, she's also thinking, like, outside, you know, of the box, like, 3 or 4 months down the road being with this person. And it's kind of very similar with these two, because they both hide behind these masks for such a long time that they really can't show how they truly are around each other, because every single time you feel, when you look at them, and it makes you want to go back and rewatch the previous seasons, be like, when was y'all truly being yourselves, and was y'all, you know, putting on that mask and such. But long story short, he came to her aid, they talked it out. Yes, she did cry a couple of times, but she even stated, like, in that moment, I really thought he was going to leave me. And I think for anyone, guy, girl, whoever, when you show that vulnerable side to your significant other, that's kind of the first thing that you initially think of is, oh my God, they're going to fucking leave me because I've shown them this one vulnerable side that I never want to show anyone. And this is why some people say, like, you be emotionless in a relationship, but you don't really want to do that. It's like the same thing as you don't want to take the baggage of your previous relationship into your newer relationship, because 50 out of 50, that is also going to fuck up your current relationship. You always want to start fresh. If you still have, I hate to say this, baggage, that's when you go into more self-love. And it makes me want to say, like, maybe these two should have a self-love type moment, but really, in a way, y'all only getting it for one episode, or really from these last 3 episodes, we're in the finale. Now is the time where you guys really, truly, 100% commit to this and wanting to be together, because you want to be with each other. You're both lovesick. That's the thing. And it's like, when he felt, because he loves her so much, and how cocky is, like, I hurt everybody who is around me. Like, you feel that for her. You really, truly feel that. And you're like, baby, like, you're the one who loves you. He's right here. Yes, but you were still being cold to him. If you would just stop. And it just took her, after that moment, and having a moment with herself and just talking it out in her head, which we've all done, where we all thought out loud and such, and we just have that conversation with ourselves, and eventually, you know, sometimes it turns good, and sometimes it turns a little ugly, but it's life, and you gotta take that shit day by fucking day. So, but I mean, yeah, now, I'm hoping, like I said, we get a really good kiss by the end of this, that these two are able to finally say, like, I love you, and I want to be with you. No mass. Mass off, take them shits off. Like, no, I want to be with you at the end of the day, regardless, until we are old and gray and such. But seriously, it is time. It's no more being around this bush anymore. It is time to sort this shit out, to finally be a couple. I want to go into it. Where are we on, like, season 4 now? Yeah, I want to go into the next season with these two finally being a couple. Even though I feel like this is possibly not going to end with them being a couple, then we're not going to see it until the next season and stuff, but that's okay. Whatever happens, I might be pissed about it for like a couple of days to a week, but I will get over it because I love these two so freaking much, and you just want everything for them. You want the best for these two. Just get the fuck together, finally. Kiss and kiss like you fucking mean it. That's all I have to say. But go ahead and pause the video, and I will see you guys in 1 second for the final part. Alrighty, final part in 3, 2, 1, go.
Ooh.
Excuse me. Goodness, goodness. Oh my God. I knew it was coming. Let me hold on for another 30 minutes and then I can go to bed. It's 3 o'clock in the morning and I'm so fucking tired. Okay. Girl. Oh my God. Chica. God, she. I'd be leaving too, but like, I don't want to be around here. Korea. It'd be like that. Get a there's some chocolates. I mean, yeah, that's awkward, but still, food! What do we like? Food! Oh, nice. Handcuffs. But she'll still love it because it's from you. Give it. It can be something that's not useless or ever. Regardless, she's gonna love it.
Baby Andy, oh my god. Oh.
Once again, she a runner, she a track star. Cause she going on his ass. She is on him. No, he doesn't hate you. I know, but so are you. Y'all are so fucking similar. That's not even funny. It's cute. Right. All I need is you. Sometimes we don't want all that stuff. Sometimes we just want you. That's all. Even when things are hard. That can't be it, though, right? Okay, I'm just saying. As long as we're together. Once again, so are you, though, babe. Yes. Remember, she wants to be with you and you only. The third wheels, god dang it. No more black or white, pure color. He said it all, y'all.
Can we also talk about the fact that Jimmy Super Rare Kaguya was in the trash for a moment?
Perfect. Right? God! Sometimes even the guy is an asshole and fucking ghosts you. Finally. Once again, finally. Oh my god. Okay, officially, now, they are a couple. We did it, ladies and gentlemen. Oh my god, I'm so happy. Like, oh, that was cute. I don't know where I would put this, like, you know, finally being a couple and, like, my list of couples finally being a couple together and such, but I mean, probably top 10, yeah, but oh my god. So final thoughts on this whole movie. This was good. I mean, I would love to see another movie as like this in four parts. I'm not mad at it. I thought it was really good, but I'm happy, finally, freaking finally. Now I just need my baby from Spy Family to get on the same situation so that they can finally be together, like, you know, just like, yes, when you finally have that couple finally get together, you'd be like, yes, we can bring the alcohol out, we can drink for these couples, because finally, thank God, they are together. But it's the best thing. But any romance series, once again, we get into the will they, won't they, is like a motherfucking drug. You crave that ish, and then when they're finally together, you just crave every little situation where they're finally just together and they get to do all the cute little coupley shit. You're just like, yes, I'm so happy for you. But then at the same time, you're sitting here realizing, like, damn, you know, you yourself, possibly, if you're not in a relationship, or you're just like, you're either in a relationship or you're not, you're trying to be like, you know, that bad bitch, or you know, that what is a bad bitch for a guy? What is that? Big bossing it up. There we go. But secretly, you're kind of like, damn, I want love. I am worthy of love. And honestly, and I'll even say that, yes, you are worthy of love. You are all of you. Like, seriously, you're going to find someone. Whether you're in a relationship or now, or you eventually are in the situation of, I just want to be on my own right now, and find more of your self-love with you until you eventually find that one. And let me tell you something, no matter what, you're always going to kiss freaking frogs before you find your prince or your princess. And that is okay as well. But finally, these two are finally together. We can put, not really a ring on it, per se. We can put just, you know, a heart. We are truly together. We can kiss and just, you know, have the cutest little dates. I'm ready. In the next season, I'm ready to see all the dates. Okay? All the freaking dates. These two are a couple now. So every single episode should at least be a date episode. If not, at least in a 12-episode series, 2 dates episodes. That's all. I'm just saying. I need to see them doing more coupley-ish. But I do like the fact that, you know, because at first, honestly, I think watching part 1 and part 2 before I got into part 3, I was like, okay, everybody's really in this. But my biggest thing at the time was, okay, where the hell is, like, Shirogane's sister? Then she pops up in part 3. So I think really the only one who didn't really make an appearance, she made it more in the opening, was Ino's, like, second in command, her best friend and such. So, I mean, she probably was there, but she was mainly only there for, like, a minute, and then boom, like, we go into somebody else. Now, with our lovely, precious boy Ishigami and his situation with his crush, I feel like she might, in this next season, finally confess or just answer his feelings, because, you know, he gave her the 3-month thing where it's like, hey, you got 3 months. It almost like he gave her an ultimatum at the end of the day. And so it's like, now, are you going to, you know, convey those feelings and return it to him? Or do you want to just be like, I want to be on my own. It's not you, it's me. Blah, blah, blah. Bullshit, bullshit, bullshit. The things that we've all heard before and such. And then, you know, hurting a potential love interest feelings and stuff like that. You know, that's the one thing I think we all kind of go through, because sometimes we do want someone. Sometimes someone can come in at the right or wrong time, but really you never know. Like I said, 1 minute I'm in that bad bitch era. I just want to be on my own, be a bad bitch, be independent as fuck, and get my own money, get my coin and such, and just focusing on me. And then there are times where I'm like, you know what? I am worthy of love. I want love and such. And sometimes I feel like maybe I kind of look for love in the wrong places and such. Or I go to the one person, like, over and over again. But okay, here, another thing about myself and me. I don't know if every girl is like this, but I can speak for me and me only. When I fall for someone, when I fall for a guy, I fall pretty hard. I blame that on anything that I personally have watched. Now, I think older me, now when I look back at myself and such, I'm like, I try not to fall very head over heels quickly. And sometimes I can still be like blinded by being in love and such, but love is hard. It's like this show in a nutshell. It is a dangerous fucking game. And 1 minute it can be up, and the next minute it could be down. There's not always a moment where it's always going to be happy, 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 joy, joy. Ask. There are going to be moments where you two are going to argue and such. And I think right now for these two, we are in the honeymoon stage. Do I think the honeymoon stage is going to last forever for these two? I would love for it to last forever for these two. But at the same time, like, in this moment, we had a real moment for these two. As not even as officially a couple yet, but now we're getting into moments where now they are officially a couple. And it's like, how are they going to handle situations like that? I don't think we're going to have a moment where, like, some other girl is going to come to Shirogane and be like, damn, you look fine. And I don't think that's going to happen, because he only sees her and vice versa. Like, and that's another thing I'll say about myself. Whoever I am in a relationship with, whatever guy I am in a relationship with, I see him. Yes, there's a whole bunch of guys around me and such. Yes, I talk to you guys on, like, freaking social media. I have a whole bunch of guy friends and stuff. I'm a guy's girl and I'm a girl's girl and such. But when I am in a relationship with someone, you are the only one who is in, like, my mind and such. Well, yes, I will still talk to all my other guy friends and such. I think it's okay, once again, to have friends of the opposite sex, even if it doesn't mean anything. I think that'll be another conversation or situation that those two will go into, even though technically they had it in the previous season, but that was when, oh hey, we weren't a couple anymore, but now we are a couple and such. I would like to see something like that officially, since they are one. But yeah, very good, very sweet. Cinematography and everything was 10 out of freaking 10. Y'all put y'all everything up in this freaking thing, and I cannot wait for the next freaking season. Everything about this was good. Kaguya Sayu, of course, ran that, and she ran with it so freaking good. I mean, once again, you know, give her all the damn awards. Like, this last year in a nutshell has really been her year. She's, the girl has been in a lot of freaking things ever since, you know, season one of this show ended, and this girl is just going places. Same thing with really this whole cast in a nutshell. I mean, of course, with Chika, that's my girl, freaking my demon girl from next door, my precious baby. Shami Cole, so of course she's an awesome. I'm trying to think for Shirogane, Ishigane, like, if I've seen them in anything else. I probably have, but I cannot think of anything. My Ino, my Mijino Yume, give her all the freaking awards again, because she's getting a lot of ish too, even after Aikatsu. So once again, it's just, you congratulate these characters, I mean these seiyuu, so much, because they be putting that damn work in, and when they do, it just, it's really good. Like, god, I don't think I've watched an anime where, like, I've possibly disliked the performance of someone and such. Maybe one day I might actually find that. Whenever I do, I will let y'all know, because oof. But I really don't think I've ever seen a show where I've had, like, a performance of somebody where I absolutely hated it the whole entire time. But seriously, this was a damn good watch. I hate the fact that it's over, because who knows whenever we're going to get the next season. Manga-wise, I have no idea, like, where they are chapter-wise and such, and how much more we have to go before this series is kind of over in a nutshell. I mean, with this ending, it kind of really wrapped up a lot of things that I was like, okay, like, we can kind of end it here and just stop the show here. But as, like, oh god, I'm using my Attack on Titan ish how I felt when I was like, I'm not gonna watch the next season. And the next thing you know, it brought me back. But with this, it's still, even though it, like, wrapped it up in a nice little bow and such, at the same time, it can still go anywhere. Like I said, I would like to see these two, you know, not only graduate, but going to college, seeing what the rest of the gang is up to and such. So, potentially, wherever we are manga-wise, yes, she could, you know, just give me my answers and stuff. Because, you know, the longer I have to wait, you know, that sucks, regardless. But, you know, at the same time, even though I have this, I also have my favorite idol, and we all know how that's going. It's only week one, and woo! I feel like, you know, in the next couple of weeks of that dang show, I'm, you know, this show is an emotional roller coaster of comedy, laughs, and tears, and anger, heartbreak, and everything. My favorite idol is an emotional roller coaster as well, of different emotions where I feel everything. And like I said, it was only the first freaking episode, but I'm here for it until the next season of Kaguya. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction for you towards the Kaguya Sama Love Is War movie. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. It really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel and make videos every single day. Join the Mattress Squad. And of course, I will see you guys officially all whenever the heck the next season comes out. For the rest of the week, for the continuation of spring anime. And then, you know, everything else is coming out. Because I have a lot on my plate before I go back to work too next week. So I have a couple more videos. One other thing that I recorded before this, that's not coming out until next Friday. And then I got a couple other things to do between tonight, later on tonight, because it is Thursday for me. And tomorrow. But yeah. Until then, I will see you guys all next time. Bye.